So the niche of a species is what it does for a living, its role in the ecosystem. A niche differentiation is the idea that different species have different roles. And you can imagine how this would be driven by evolution. So the selection to be different from other species to reduce competition. And to illustrate this, I'm at Holkham on the North Norfolk coast, where there's areas of grass and open water. And yet in this area, I've seen one species of swan, I've seen four species of geese, two species of shell duck, seven species of duck. So there's all this different waterfowl coexisting in this same location. So how do they manage to achieve that? And I should explain in this video, I've cheated. I'm going to cut in bits of video that I've taken in other locations. I haven't taken it all here today. So some of the obvious differences are swans with a long neck that they can dig vegetation, pull up vegetation for deep in the water. And then geese with these sturdy, short beaks, perfect for shearing off grasses, and those that have thicker beaks can dig around in the mud and pull up roots and the like. But really it's the ducks where there's a great diversity, where really there's the puzzle to explain how these coexist. And many of them do look very similar. Some of them are quite obviously different. So pochard feed by diving and feeding on water weeds, particularly stoneworts. Tufted ducks also dive, but these feed on animal matter. They feed on mollusks, they feed on shells, such as freshwater mussels and insects. And this distinction between diving ducks and surface feeding ducks is fundamental. And they're very different. So diving ducks want to be heavy so they don't keep bobbing to the surface. And so they have a heavy body with thick bones, and the bones are filled with marrow, and they have short wings and a rounded body. Whereas the surface feeding ducks are much lighter, they have thinner bones, bones filled with air, they have long wings. And you can see this when you look at the species. You can see how the surface feeding ducks are higher in the water, and with those long wings makes them look rather like a punt. Whereas the diving ducks are lower in the water because they're heavier and got a much more rounded back because of their short wings, and they look rather like an overturned punt. And this also reflects how they fly. So diving ducks have heavier, shorter wings, and so it's harder for them to fly. They have to flap more. Surface feeding ducks, lighter, longer wings, flap less. And when they're taking off, diving ducks have to run in order to take off. Surface feeding ducks can just jump in the air and fly off. But it's in amongst the surface feeding ducks that really there's the greatest similarity. A lot of them, particularly the females, look very similar. So how do they differ? Let's start with the teal, which is the smallest of our ducks. This feeds on seeds in shallow water. It can get to those shallow waters very easily because of their small size. And also because they're small, they have low energy requirements. Garganey looks similar, but they feed on the surface, they don't upend as much, and particularly they overcome the problems of winter by flying to Africa, so avoiding the risk of wetlands freezing. The mallard is our most familiar duck. It's got feeds on a whole diversity of species. It's very much a generalist. The gadwall, by comparison, is a specialist on water weeds. So you'd think it would be restricted to the shallow areas where it can upend. But its party trick is that it steals weeds from diving coot. So when they come to the surface, they take the weeds from them. And so that means its niche is not just the edge, shallow waters, as with other diving, other dabbling ducks, but also deep water, because it's stealing from coot. Pintail are a beautiful, elegant species with a narrow bill and this long neck. They specialize particularly on seeds or to take insects, and that narrow beak is perfect for extracting those out of the mud. And with the long neck, they can dabble in an upend and feed in deeper water than the other surface feeding ducks. And that's what you always see. You always see them in deeper water. Many species of duck have lamellae, a comb-like structure around the edge of the bill. That means they can filter out food items from the water body. Shoveler take this to an extreme. They have more lamellae and larger lamellae. And that means that they can suck up water, spit it through these lamellae, and extract the food items. This is just the same strategy as flamingos adopt. So they want lots of food items in the water column, so they'll swim around in circles, and very often they'll swim around with other shoveler, disturbing all the food from the sediment so they can then filter it out. And then finally, we have the wigeon, which is a specialist on the stems and leaves of plants, particularly grasses. And it has a short, strong bill, and its legs are further forward than other dabbling ducks, which means it can walk much better because it spends all its time walking. And so we can see how just in one location, you can have a diversity of different species that can occur. And these species will occupy different niches. And the idea of the niche is fundamental to ecology. The idea of niche differentiation explains how many species can co-occur in the same site. So I've illustrated this with waterfowl. I could equally have illustrated it with bees or albatrosses or orchids. And it's a key concept for conservation as well. If you're to preserve a species, you really need to know what its niche is, what its requirements are. And if you're creating an area of habitat, you really want to know the range of habitats that are here and the diversity of niches of the species present. So the niche and niche differentiation are key concepts in ecology and conservation.